All right, guys, GoToBoy32 here, checking it out. So we're sitting here on the review table, and I got a couple of items out here, and just follow along with the story, we're going to get there. Yesterday, or in the previous video, we talked about charging handles that are going to go, one, on the pandemic build. And we talked about how clones and, you know, cheaper products and things of that nature. But one of the things that I have to do is I have to take this guy right here out. This is the Bear Creek Arsenal. This is their billet upper receiver set with a 1/8 twist carbine length gas system AR-15 upper with just their simple stuff. But as you can see, it is a billet. And we'll talk about this in detail in a later video. But part of doing a review on this thing is I have to take it out and I want to show the accuracy, and we're going to check accuracy with a couple different rounds, the 55 grain Federal, 62 grain green tips, and we'll run some 72 grain through it. And thanks to the guys over there at the Patreon, I'm able to buy ammo on occasion when you can find it, or, you know, actually do reloads for that upcoming Snipers Unknown challenge. But anyway, thanks to you guys. I really appreciate your help and all that. But in any case, one of the things that I like to do, especially on these specific scopes, is I want to incorporate what is called a built-in 20 MOA. In other words, what happens is that you have a rifle scope, and this has zero MOA, minute of angle, built into it. Now, if you buy a rifle scope mount and it says 20 MOA, what that means is that there is a built-in angle. So this thing is zero MOA, and what happens, and I'm just going to exaggerate this, is that it has 20 MOA. So in other words, instead of sitting flat like this, it kind of sits at an angle like this. That's exaggerating. Now, what does that do? Well, if you are working with turrets or actually with a BDC or a reticle, what that does is enables you to zero this thing, and it has 20 MOA already built into the turret system, so you actually get more out of your turrets. Okay, so anyway, what we're going to do is I wanted to put together, take this scope mount off. This is an American Defense, a really good one. And I wanted to find something that was a little bit more economical. Guys, I'm testing rifles and all kinds of stuff out on an hourly basis, and it gets expensive after a while. So I looked on Amazon, and I actually found a pretty cool deal. Now, again, like yesterday, we were talking about, one, how you have a Radiant Raptor, and then you have this imitation here. The imitation might be just as good. All right, so I'm a big fan of Warn Tactical. They make excellent scope mounts. One of the reasons I do love them is that on the interior, in the threads, these are steel inserts. Also, hell, this is a QD. This is a 34 millimeter. You have, this is a 30 millimeter opening, 30 millimeter tube. And then on this one, this was the one that I was running on the SUK rifle, Snipers Unknown rifle. This is a 34 millimeter. Now, the cool part about it is that it is light. Probably a lot lighter than the American Defense, but I don't know. But what I saw was, is I needed a 30 millimeter tube scope mount, and I wanted 20 MOA built into it. And then I found this guy on Amazon, and it is, in my mind, a real close, not, I don't want to say a knockoff, but real close to the Warn Tactical. It is 66-1 aluminum. There's your screws. It does have a torque head screws in it right there, as you can see. And it is a screw Titan with a half inch nuts, just like the other scope mounts, just like the Warn scope mounts. Let's see right here. Ta-da. But it says Warhunt USA. Now, is this thing made in the USA? I can't find anything on it that says made in China anywhere, but I don't know. You know what? Real quickly, let me check on the website on the Amazon. I'll put a link down below to this guy too, because believe it or not, with a built-in 20 MOA, I think I paid $54 for this guy. And then they have the 34 millimeter that are like $59. Stand by. Let's check that out. Hold on. Nope. It doesn't tell me anywhere where they're made, but they do make them in multiple colors, We've got them in blue, gold, and red. I will tell you this, the finish is excellent. I've actually got one of the other scopes already mounted up with one of these things. I mean, at $54, you really can't beat it. The other ones, just a regular, are $49. So if you need a cheap, economical, and I don't like to use the word cheap, economical scope mount, this is not a bad option. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and take this American Defense off of here. We're going to mount this guy on here. And guys, literally, to get a 20 MOA scope mount in an American Defense, you're probably going to pay $160, $170. Well worth it. But if you're not out there, you know, patrolling the elements and you don't really need something like that, this guy right here, I'm going to guess, is going to hold us pretty clear. So let's go ahead. I'm going to mount this guy on there. But before we do that, let's see here. The total weight, because, you know, we like pulling out the old, what do you call this thing? This guy. Let's go back to fluid. Oh, I don't need fluid ounce. Milliliters. Get all our screws on there. Total weight of this guy is 6.8 ounces without that one screw. This guy with the QD mount is 8.4. So two additional ounces with the Warn Tactical. But yeah, look at that. Yeah. You wonder? Flattery. Copies. Let's go ahead and put this thing on. Here we go. Stand by. All right, went ahead and just mounted this guy on here. I will tell you this, man. If you look at it, the seams all match up. It's about a 2-inch overbore, center line of bore to the center line of your scope. One of the things I failed to mention is that, and it's a pet peeve of mine, is that these screws right here, the nuts, are staked. So when you back those out, they won't come down or come out. The screws, we actually had a spare screw right here. And I'll tell you this, man, not a bad little deal. Again, I don't know where they're made. Probably going to assume that they're going to be made in China at this price. But, you know, WarhuntUSA, you would think. But in any case, that's it. I'm going to put the link down below to a video. A good friend of mine named Bald and Curious is trying to raise money for a very dear family friend who has run into some difficulties. He is going to raffle off a very nice 1911 500 rounds and some really cool shooting glasses, $100 an entry. But get on over there, take a look at the video. It's for a great cause. Yeah, you had a chance to win a really, really cool firearm. So anyway, that's it, man. The Warhunt USA scope mount, not a bad little deal. And then I tell you what we're going to do. We're actually going to go ahead and check for accuracy with this barrel. And then we're going to break out this guy right here. Oh yeah, Primary Arms, the SLX. This is their MD25. This guy's got the ACSS CQB reticle in it. And we're going to throw a little magnifier on it and see how she does out the distance. It's going to be a lot of fun. It's CodaBoy32. You like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't already done so. Support red, white, and blue. God bless America. God bless those men and women in uniform 24/7 for our freedom. Because freedom is not free. And we're going to get ourselves a new Supreme Court justice here very soon. And it'll be interesting to see how nasty and vile they get on the other side. Nasty and vile. CodaBoy32. I am out of here. Man, that is not a bad looking scope mount. $54. 20 MOA built in. Oh yeah.